Kyrie, and welcome to Parsing John. Today we are going to finish off this paragraph of the text with verse 34. Once we're done with this and we've taken a look at the Latin one, we're going to take the two texts together and compare verses 29 through 34 all together, probably across two actual videos. Let's go ahead and grab our rubric. This is everything that we're looking for as we take a look at the text. Make sure that everything is reasonably within the screen and get started. Kago heoraka kai memartureka hoti hutos esten ho huios tu theo. Pretty short one today. Straight off the bat, we've run into Kago again. This is our third instance of this, and we should expect it to appear again and again and again whenever there is direct discourse in the text. But it's still within our greater quote starting right there, I believe. And I, nominative, singular. Heoraka is our verb. This one is, since we've got the kappa alpha here, it is our, I believe, our first person, which would make sense with ego. Singular, perfect, active, and indicative. Ra'o opsomai eidon heoraka. Yep. I saw. And since this is a perfect tense, the way that this normally works in English is that perfect has, of course, a past action, but it's a past action with effects in the present, whereas an aorist tense would be a past completed action, which may or may not. The tense doesn't implicate anything in that regard. So I saw, and up until this point. Kai, and memartureka, we've got kappa alpha again. So this would be martureo, martureso, e marturesa, me martureka. Perfect again. The exact same one, so I'm just going to pull it over and put it right there. And witnessed. And we could add in parentheses or bracket if you prefer. Do them both. Missed. And continued. Until now. Close bracket, close parent. Okay. Hoti, that, or because. Hutos esten. Esten is our verb. We've seen it up here before. We don't really need to parse it again. Get the general idea from this. So we can just say, is hutos. Another repetition of that right there. So just say nominative. This one. I keep using the wrong one, sorry. Intentional there, but not intentional. This one is ho huius. Ho is from ho he to, our article. Not to be confused with hos he ho. This is nominative, singular, masculine. This means son. Also a predicate from hutos. Tu theo. So we've got our omicron u right there. I'm not u, upsilon. This tells us genitive, singular, the very least second declension, but we know that theu is masculine. Of the god. Period. Since this ends our paragraph, without knowing the context of the next one, I'm going to go ahead and put in quote marks. There's our sentence. And I saw and witnessed, with the implication that he continued witnessing up until this point and continued seeing, although not necessarily every single second. That would be ridiculous. Almost had to be glued to Jesus at that point. I should start the verse over, sorry. And I saw and witnessed, with the implication and continued until now, that this one is the son of the God. Right, now we want to take a look at the greater context, verse 29 through the end of this passage. On the next day, he sees the Jesus coming to him, and he says, look, or here is the Lamb of the God, the one lifting up or removing the sin of the world. This one is for the sake of whom I said, after me comes man who before me became, because he was before me. And I had not known him, but in order that he may be revealed to the Israel, because of this I came in water baptizing. And John witnessed, saying that I beheld, or I saw, the Spirit descending as dove from heaven, and it remained on him. And I had not known him, but the one having sent me to baptize in water, that one said to me, On whom you may see the Spirit descending and remaining on him, this one is the one baptizing in the Holy Spirit. And I saw and witnessed and continued until now that this one is the Son of the God. There is our entire paragraph in all of its context together. Really, really cool passage, especially the implication of this right here. What's going on there? Awesome. But anyway, now we need to take a look, see if we have any nouns of a particular type without articles. Take a look through here. We only really have two nouns, huios and theou, and both of them have articles, so there's nothing for us to look at. And we are done with this verse and this passage. Thank you very much for joining me. I hope taking a look at all of these verses has been helpful for you. And I hope you continue along with me as we continue with this chapter. I think I've said the word continue about 10 times now. I'll leave you with that. Good night. Have a good day. All of the appropriate phrases.